perfluorokills. Okay, they're called PFOS for short, which honestly isn't that much better. We've used this stuff since the 1940s. But now there's more evidence than ever that it can cause cancer and tons of other bad stuff. They've been found at high levels in water systems all over the country. What is it exactly, and what are we doing about it? PFOS refers to a class of thousands of synthetic chemicals. They repel water and grease. Since the 1940s, companies have used this stuff to make things non-stick, or waterproof, or stain-resistant. Let's play a game. It's like Where's Waldo, but with PFOS instead of Waldo. Can you find the PFOS in this photo? How about here? And it's also right here. In me, not the milkshake. The CDC says they're in the bloodstream of nearly everybody in the US. They're called forever chemicals because they stick around for a really long time. Over several decades, research has linked them to cancer, high cholesterol, and problems with immune function, fertility, and child development. Over time, scientists have drastically lowered the standard for what they consider a safe level of PFOS. And they've been found at high levels in water systems all over the country, especially around military bases and certain manufacturing plants. But as disturbing as those PFOS levels are, they're not technically illegal. There are still no federal limits on PFOS in drinking water. The Environmental Protection Agency has a recommendation for what it considers safe, but nothing enforceable. In June 2018, the CDC published a major study that found that PFOS could pose threats at levels up to 10 times lower than what the EPA says is safe. People are kind of freaking out about it.
The Trump administration has called the contamination a public relations nightmare.
Given the indestructible nature, how useful they are to us in everyday life, and their toxicity, they scare me.
Governor Rick Snyder is asking the state legislature to approve millions of dollars aimed at fighting drinking water contaminants.
In 2018, at an EPA summit on PFOS, the agency didn't even allow a group of journalists to come in. And some people say the government has delayed taking action. The EPA is currently deliberating on whether it will set max limits on PFOS in tap water.
Americans count on EPA every time they turn on their faucet. That's why communities across the nation have asked us to provide a comprehensive approach to understanding PFOS and protecting drinking water.
But people still say the EPA isn't moving fast enough. For one, it's focusing mostly on two types of PFOS instead of the whole class of chemicals.
The problem is really that we don't know exactly how much of this stuff is entering our waterways. So the scope is really only starting to be understood. And that's really where the EPA action is needed.
Reed says that if we at least have an enforceable drinking water standard, we can know how much of this stuff is actually in our water and take steps from there. But even if the EPA is acting slowly, there are some signs of progress. In 2015, DuPont finally phased out the type of PFOS it uses in its Teflon products. People are pushing for companies to clean up places they've contaminated. And states like Washington and Michigan are taking action on their own. As people continue to push for more answers, actions, and solutions, maybe PFOS won't stick around forever after all.